Oh, hi there, so you like math? I mean math. No, it doesn't matter, here's a quick question. This is a piece of gravel. When broken, it has 10% chance to drop a flint. How many pieces of gravel do you need to get one flint? Okay, I'm just playing. I know that you know we are not actually destroying the gravel, and therefore we need just one piece of gravel to get one flint. But now explain me why the Hypixel flint costs like 20 times more than gravel, when literally all you have to do is... Okay, fair enough. Or is it so? Obviously we're gonna use tools, more specifically an efficiency 5 fortune 3 shovel, because if you didn't know, fun fact, with fortune 3 you have actually 100% chance to get a flint. Okay, so apparently on Hypixel we can't apply fortune 3 on the shovel, but instead there is this whole separate item that does the same exact thing, which is, yeah, sure, good job Hypixel. Anyway, so now with that we can mine gravel faster and drop flint every time, which is, yeah, sure, but still no. You see, the thing that is actually stopping us is placing gravel, and if there only was a way for us to place all that gravel with one single click... Yeah, that's right, we are doing it again. How many times have I already said that word on my channel? A builder's wand. Like, I don't even know what that means we're thinking while adding this item, that people are going to use it to build? Yeah, didn't think so. Oh, and yeah, by the way, by placing all blocks with one click, I meant 240, but that's close enough. And now we are talking about 18 flints that transfers to 400 coins per second, 24,000 per minute, which honestly could be a quick, very simple, and almost not totally terrible way to make money. Yep, it still sucks. But fortunately for us, it can be easily fixed by changing one thing, a tiny difference that makes big difference. We are simply going to place it one block higher, and what that does is making the gravel fall onto the carpet, and instead of placing 240 gravel we are breaking 240 gravel, and for some reason it's still dropping flint. Okay, obviously not from all gravel, but at the default 10% rate, which is still 24 flints that transfers to 550 coins per click. Not per second, per click, which you can do more than one per second, I would imagine. And now if you would start multiplying it by 2, 3, 4, 10 clicks per second, the numbers are starting to become big, like... really big. Okay, obviously we won't get even close to that number, but I don't think there is something stopping us either. I mean, as far as I know, there isn't any cooldown or something, and in theory even 10 clicks per second should be possible, but in practice there is just server response time and us being humans, which are the main reasons we won't be able to get too crazy with it, and that we also can't do much about. But there's also a design that we have to do pretty much everything about, but just be aware that it won't be perfect either, because in spite of appearances, it's not so simple, mainly because it is so simple that there is way too many designs that would work, and it's not so simple to just tell which one is the best before testing them. And there is way too many designs that would work, I'm not gonna spend hours looking for a best way to click on a wall. But let me give you a few examples that I was thinking of. Oh, I also probably should mention that placing gravel is only half of the process and we still have to collect all that flint and gravel. So my first idea was very simple, just a few walls of gravel with a water collection system beneath. The drops fall to the water, then they go to the middle where they get collected by me. The gravel goes back to my inventory from where it can be used again, and flint gets compacted to the enchanted form using personal compactor. The rest of the gravel is in your stash from where you can easily access it by our good old friend slash pickup stash. Which is also, by the way, the general idea of that whole idea of clicking on a wall, and it's basically the same for each design, the only difference is how we gonna place and collect gravel. And this first design has one main flaw. So the only way for the drops to fall to the water is to fall through the block they got destroyed by, which means we can't use something like slabs, and the only way would be to use something like torches on the ladder so the items can fall through, but even with that the drops were getting stuck, which isn't exactly good. Attempting to fix that, I tried using hoppers, which means I will have to use redstone, which already isn't a good sign. But finally I ended up with this, which has to be like the best thing I ever built. Not because of the functionality, yeah it still sucks, but it looks cool. which also has some value, right? Just look at them go, isn't that nice? Anyway, now about the person I told you it still suck. I lied. Actually, it's working perfectly fine. Until it doesn't. So basically, it turns out there are more items going into the hopper than out of the hopper, causing the hopper to eventually fill up, which isn't exactly good. I mean, I probably could do some changes and make it work, but then I would have to break all this and think and build a new thing, and then probably break the new thing and think again and make a newer thing that the thing I was thinking is going to be a good thing, which isn't exactly good, which isn't exactly good for me, because I would have to think about the things I don't want to think about. And that's why the last design is actually the simplest of all. I figured, why make it complicated when a wall that you can click on should be just a wall you can click on? So I made this. And I know it may seem like a bit more than just a wall you can click on, and it is more. Walls you can click on. Place it in such a way that we can just hold right click and move our character to the left while placing about 1000 gravel in a second. And getting about 100 flint, which can be traded to a considerable amount of coins considering the amount of time we just spent to get them. And now to not waste time waiting for the gravel to fall, we just move a few steps forward to place another 1000 gravel. Oh, and yeah, if you're wondering why I don't just make a long line, so it's because our not so good old friend the 16 blocks area around the outside of which everything just stops working, which is kind of forcing us to make everything in this tiny square. I mean, I guess you could use your old... But anyway, the rest is pretty much the same thing, just casually swinging from left to right while making thousands of coins every second. But what after we get to the end? Literally no one was going to ask. Well, we just turn around and do the same thing facing the other side and picking up all the flint and gravel on the way. And finally, to refill your inventory, like, is that even a question? Do you even smash pickup star, bro? But yeah, I think it's worth mentioning that you will have to do that more often only at the beginning, because after a few rounds there will be enough gravel just laying on the ground so you can literally just hold right click and stare on a wall. Anyhow, I could talk a lot more about the details and other ideas and other details that could lead to other ideas, but I feel like that would be too much details and no one would want to watch it.
Oh, I do.
Shut up, nerd. So you're probably wondering how much money I was making. So I did a few tests from 8 mil. On average, which is like even more than I was expecting. In my last video I said, I don't think there is something easier than getting rid of items from your inventory for 3 mil per hour. And here we are, staring on a wall. For 8 mil per hour. Never mind, the price just decided to skyrocket. For 60 mil per hour. Okay, I don't think we can count that. It's still kind of funny, I can say I was making 60 mil per hour by staring on a wall.
But didn't you say the best way to make money? Like, there are so many.
No, I said the most broken. It's not even close to the best way. But for that, you either need hundreds of millions worth of equipment or a massive brain, which is fair. Where for this, you need a builder's wand. And like, I don't know, you're just staring on a wall, you don't even need a brain. You see my point, you shouldn't be able to make that much money. Well, at least this time we are not breaking the economy. I mean, players still have to exchange money, so we are good, right? The only difference is that most of the gravel will become flint. That can be used to craft a tarantula silk, that can be used to craft a flycatcher for 1 million coins instead of 12, that can boost minions by 20%. Oh. Yikes. Well, good thing no one will ever think of using it that way. And besides, this method is probably like way dead already, so what even is the point, you may ask? What is the point in anything?